We're back with more Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. You're invited to join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, Ian here.
And Mark.
You can also join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. We're talking about what has been termed as a crisis for young men by Phil Zimbardo. You might recognize his name. He's the famous psychologist who wrote the Stanford Prison Experiment. And that's on its own a fascinating thing to look into. But this has to do with young men today. He's saying there's a real problem with addiction to pornography and video games, sort of in tandem, maybe not at the same time, but you know, close proximity to one another. And he's saying it's creating a real problem. He did a study on 20,000 young men and their relationships with video games and pornography. The focus is on those young men who play those video games to excess and who do it in social isolation. That is, they are alone in their room.
Yeah, I wonder how much of this, and I share his concerns, but I wonder how much of this is the older generation just worrying about how the younger generation does things.
Could be. Well, let's go back to Dave. Mark, you had a question for him. Dave said he has been a psychologist in the past, I think. Dave, yeah. Are you still with us?
Once a psychologist, always.
I'm still with you, and I am very grateful that you have posed this question to me for some input. We might do some good here.
Yep. Let me ask the question.
Can you re-ask the question, Mark?
Yeah. The question is basically, do you see in the changing roles of men in society, in many ways, women's changing roles offers them more options. Men's changing roles seem to be sort of the destruction of this protector-provider role that is so inherent in what we're taught, our socialization, that kind of thing. And what are the do you see negative effects, Dave?
Not even a little bit, and let me speak to it a bit, if I might. That is to say, if a male chooses to be as feminine as he can get, if he makes himself pretty, if he does up his hair, if his way of walking, I again say, so what? If I get a girl client that she is all football and wrestling and wants to learn to be a diesel mechanic, I say, go, girl, go. There is not one thing abnormal about either of them. We may live in a world where people are quick to judge harshly these traits, but there is nothing that makes them even a little bit abnormal in one man's opinion. I also had the good fortune to study human sexuality under the best in the business, and I do believe I am giving you the official position of the APA.
So you're saying that Zimbardo here is totally off base, that this isn't a crisis at all, that these thousands of young males aren't having a problem. As long as they're having fun, you're saying go for it.
Zimbardo, I ask you why. What is the harm that's being done? Where do you see an abnormality?
What if they're losing a job? What if they're losing a girlfriend over this?
I suppose it could get to that extreme, and in that case, they'd have to look at it. But it's nothing to me that an effeminate male, a masculine female, for sure, that you're not going to say that's an abnormality.
I'll give you that. I totally agree there.
Right,
everybody's different.
What Zimbardo's saying here is that the demasculinization of the male gender is what, and he's blaming it on video games and pornography, or at least to some extent, he's associating it with those two. And I'm not concerned with that in the same way. I am, however, concerned, Dave, with sort of the different social roles available to females today. We're not telling males exactly what they can, you know, what they should be doing in so many ways. I kind of feel like the male
should be doing.
Okay, the male gender. I will make my case. The male gender has become a vestigial gender, kind of like the appendix as a vestigial organ. We're not needed any longer in sort of society in the same way that we were. The big shoulder girdle can pretty much be handled with lifting heavy machinery, a gun to protect yourself, things like that. You can get one of those little reachy items to get the cans off the top of the top shelf. It doesn't matter that we're a little taller anymore. Furniture can be moved around with those little pads on the legs now. And most women didn't have problems killing bugs on their own anyway. It was just giving their husbands something to do. So I kind of feel like there's little to do as far as a man goes in sort of our traditional roles. I'm not saying people shouldn't be able to do what they want. What I'm saying is in many cases, young men could be conceivably confused. This doesn't happen in my life. It's just like, what do we do? What are we here for? And I don't know.
Well, the message you're hearing from me is, so what is the big deal? Where is this doing harm to anybody? Let them express their feelings as best they're able. I can see where there was I've heard that you can actually have violence involved in sex on a video to a point where they actually kill or seriously rape and harm somebody. And I've never seen
anything. Snuff films are, for the most part, just false. I mean, they don't actually exist. But Dave, thanks for the call
tonight.
They exist. I appreciate it.
When you say actually exist, you're saying they don't. They are.
Like, as in real snuff films, they don't really exist for the most part.
You mean people actually being killed on film?
For the purpose of sort of sexual gratification or whatever, those don't really exist. I mean, they're very much overblown.
Very much overblown.
Yeah, maybe
yes.
You could find some evidence of. I mean, obviously, there's people who've been killed on film, but not necessarily for the purpose of creating a snuff film.
Yeah, well, there's disturbing trends in pornography that bother me. I've seen pornographic films where the man's choking the woman. Not particularly hard or anything like this, but this is a relatively common thing in porn. And I find this incredibly upsetting and demeaning.
I'm with you there, but going from S&M to snuff film is a long departure.
Yeah.
And snuff films are mostly mythology. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And if you do find a snuff film, it's a fake, right? So
well, of course,
an actual
but generally,
snuff film.
Yeah.
Well, the definition of a snuff film is somebody who, there's a participant in a porn who is snuffed out at some point during the film for real. That's what a snuff film is supposed to be. Anyway, let's continue here. 855-450-FREE is the number. Jason in Newport, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hi, Jason.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
I tend to agree with both you guys and the doctor that both of those are contributing factors, but I think the main factor is that, according to, modern day feminists, masculinity isn't, approved of. In fact, it's something to be looked down upon. It's like whenever you see these weird little, coffee sipping hipsters running around with beards, trying to grasp to some, fleeting, masculinity, I think it's, we're in a bad way.
Is it a tenet? I mean, I can't say I study feminism real deep. Is it really a tenet of newer feminism that men shouldn't be manly or something like that?
There's some of that in there with the boys are stupid, throw rocks at them t-shirt that was, out there at one point. The in giving girls power, girl power, to some extent you have, it's a short step from giving power to a group, empowering a group, to taking power from another group. I mean, these tend to go hand in hand in the course of human history. Rather than raising a group up, you want to pull the other one down. And, men and women have always kind of had their little things going back and forth. I tend to think that women aren't as complicated to figure out as men would claim. And men certainly aren't that complicated to figure out. But they can have their moody spells, too.
Right. And I actually, did some research on this just the other day. And the overwhelming theme was destroy the patriarchy. Destroy everything that is man.
Well, and, the patriarchy. Let's define the patriarchy real quick, because this is the slippery word, which I dislike it simply because of what it does. It just drives a wedge between people.
Jason, thanks for your call tonight.
The patriarchy is sort of the system. It's the feminist's term for the system, whatever the system is. They view it in a fashion that,
one that is male-dominated.
Yeah, it's a male-dominated system, but I don't see that. I think that women have been along, women have probably been in charge for as long as women and men have been coupling, That's my point of view on it. But the patriarchy doesn't mean let's get rid of all men.
All right, there's more on the way here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, or Skype into the show here at username lrn.fm. There's more Free Talk Live up next.
Times sure have changed since GEICO started saving people money over 75 years ago. We didn't have video games like today. But that's not to say we didn't have fun. One of my favorite games was Don't Get Kicked by the Goat. Now that's some real excitement, especially when someone lost. Yep, back then we knew two things, how to have a good time, and that Geico was always a good deal.
Geico, saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years.
The results are in. For the treatment of nasal allergy symptoms, nothing is more effective than Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of the worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. And in a recent clinical study with Nasacort going nose-to-nose with Flonase, more people prefer Nasacort. For more information, visit Nasacort.com. Nasacort. Use as directed.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free and join us here. Talk about addiction, specifically addiction to video games and pornography. Now, it doesn't have to be an and thing, but that's what Phil Zimbardo, the author of the Stanford Prison Experiment, is saying is a problem with young males. And I'm not real clear in which countries, if it's Western countries or what, but they did a study, an in-depth look into the lives of 20,000 young men and their relationships with video games and pornography. Zimbardo says it's a crisis and that there's a new form of addiction that is really damaging people's lives. One guy says that when he's in class, he wishes he was playing World of Warcraft. When he's with a girl, Says he wishes that he was watching pornography because he'll never be rejected. Let's continue here with your calls and thoughts. Also, want to let you know first about Fort Galt.
Yeah, what Fort Galt is an interesting concept. What they're doing is they're going through Bensonwood, the big, really sort of big-time boutique builder up here in New England, and they're going to build some condominiums down in Chile. And these aren't what, when you think of a condominium, you think of, like a living space that's, it's a house-sized living space. These tend to be much smaller. They're really intended to just be places to sleep, and there's going to be a much more sort of communal space. What they're trying to do is attract entrepreneurs, free spirits, travelers, people like that down there who can collaborate on ideas and create something new and different. I think it's a really interesting project. They have a fantastic website and really great videos to look at. And they're getting this project off the ground. It doesn't require a great, you don't have to pay all up front or anything like that. It's not a big risk from what they're doing as far as the amount of money you've got to put in and that sort of thing. I think it's fascinating. Go check out the website. It's at fortgalt.com. That's F-O-R-T as in fort, and Galt as in John Galt, G-A-L-T. fortgalt.com.
All right, so Mark, you were, I think, commenting on the patriarchy, and I don't think you got a chance to really say everything you wanted to there.
Well, I was just really talking about what it was. The gentleman commented on it, and I think it's a terrible loaded word. I think feminism is a terrible loaded word. I get why it was called what it was in the past, but as far as making the genders equal these days, there's all kinds of disparities on both sides of the gender equation, mm-hmm. and feminism is a word that should be relegated to the dustbin of history. What it does is, nobody thinks that calling myself, some kind of white pride advocate, that I'm looking for, racial equality. That just doesn't sound the same.
You're not saying you're a white pride.
No, but if I were to use that terminology, I would sound like a bigot.
Yeah.
Instead of somebody who's just proud of my race.
You likely would be a bigot.
There's times that those terminologies go hand in hand. But
I'd like to see the time when they don't.
I don't know. You've just opened the door. So anyway.
You brought it up.
The feminist term is a gender-specific term talking about equality. That doesn't make any sense. The patriarchy is also another loaded term. I prefer sort of the system, the way things are, this historical system we've been given, or whatever, something that describes what we've got.
All right. I mean, does it become a matriarchy after 51% of the government goons are women? Is that, how do you determine, does it have to be that 51% of the people in government are women, or that 51% of corporate executives are women? At what point will it become a matriarchy as opposed to a patriarchy?
Well, if feminists have a problem with the way things are, they need to stop talking to men and start talking to women about what their problems are, if they're not doing that already. I mean, I was raised by my mother and my grandmother. My father was rarely around. I went to every single one of my elementary school teachers, except for my music teacher, were all women. I had, this is 100%. By the time I'm in my formative years, all psychiatrists agree, your formative years, what they are, almost in nursery school, all women, entirely populated by women. How is it that I grew up to be such a bigot? We did that.
All right, let's go to Bob. He's in Vegas. Bob, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello there.
Hi, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So basically, I just wanted to start off with an anecdote, and that is my previous – I just wanted to say that my position on porn is I think that it should be legalized. I think that it's good. I think that it serves a purpose. However, all things in moderation, at one point, due to my, dependency on porn and the fact that I would always want more and more severe porn, more and more hardcore porn, what I ended up having an issue with was – I would not be able to, and most men have this problem, I wasn't able to keep an erection with a condom. I had to have anal sex, doggy style, unprotected in order to have sex. That was when I...
Because of, the risk factors? Because you needed to make sure it was as exciting as the porn? Is that why?
It's just something like I just... it was just desensitization over an extended period of time. I started watching porn when I was 9. I started watching hardcore S&M when I was 10.
Jeez.
And ever since then, I just kind of gotten more and more and more and more and more. You know, and
well, the thing is, it's hard to compare apples to it's hard to compare apples to apples in this case, because if you started watching porn at age 9, then obviously you don't know what your erectile factors would have been had you never seen porn, right? Like, maybe you would still have those same issues.
Well, no, because now, for example, I have, and a lot of it is you initially get desensitized, so you're not as excited, so you can't keep it up. And then that happens a couple of times, and then you start having performance anxiety. Now that I don't have performance anxiety, I can go on with a condom vaginal, any position, for up to 2 hours at a time.
Okay, so what you're saying is you've beaten...
At the very beginning, it wasn't a health issue, it was a mental issue.
So what you're saying is you have ended your porn addiction and have overcome your issues as a result?
Well, I mean, I can still watch porn. I still watch porn. I still watch, you know, S&M here, you know, regular stuff there, you know, lesbian porn here. I watch whatever I want, but I don't watch it day in, day out. And because I've got...
What are you down to? Give me an example. What was your level of addiction when you had a problem, and, like, how often do you look at porn now in comparison?
Well, I would watch porn twice a day, and now I watch it maybe once every 3 days.
Okay. Thanks, Bob, for your call and sharing your story tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So Bob's saying, you know, the more you watch the porn, perhaps the less ability one has in the bedroom.
I suppose. I don't know.
And Zimbardo did say earlier in the story here from the independent.co.uk, that there is a particular issue that is affecting some young men, not necessarily all of them, the PIED, porn-induced erectile dysfunction, where he says young boys who should be virile are now having a problem getting an erection. So maybe that's what our caller there was talking about. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Zimbardo blames negative images of men in the American media, showing men as slobs, undesirable, and only wanting to get laid, and being inadequate in doing that. He also called for better sex education in schools, which should focus not only on biology and safety, but also on emotions, physical contact, and romantic relationships. I don't think that the government can do sex education really very well at all, no matter what they're focusing on. But we'll come back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. We're here live on the Saturday edition of Free Talk Live, and you can share your experience with porn and video game addiction.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey, neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years. Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822, or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated. So send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you a sneezer? If you're not, can you get close to one? I don't literally mean someone sneezing. Sneezer, as defined by marketing guru Seth Godin, is an opinion leader. When a sneezer mentions something, other people catch what Godin calls the idea virus. Seth Godin says some people are more likely to tell their friends about a great new idea. So identifying and courting sneezers is a key success factor for idea merchants. His book, Unleashing the Idea Virus, is the most downloaded ebook in history, and you can download the whole book free. That's how he's making his idea contagious. Click tips, tricks, and other stuff to help you cut through the clutter at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype username here is lrn.fm. Maybe you have had a personal experience with an addiction to either pornography or video games or both. Phil Zimbardo, the infamous study, the author of the study of the Stanford prison experiment, has said this is a crisis for young men in America and in other parts of the world, presumably as well, which young men who have become addicted to these things, both pornography and video games. And he says it's causing real issues in their lives, could be even causing erectile dysfunction. Of course, Psychology Today points out that there is, according to a review of PubMed, the largest online database of medical literature, it reveals there is not a single published study linking pornography and erectile dysfunction. Now, of course, that doesn't mean that there isn't a link, but that there's not a study necessarily showing that there is one.
And considering the amount of money that Western governments throw at silly studies, you'd think that there would be.
Now, they do say here that a search for the terms erectile dysfunction pornography yields 52 publications. Of those, the bulk are studies that use pornography or visual sexual stimuli to test erectile dysfunction. In fact, urologists and researchers have found that pornography viewing is an effective, non-invasive, and reliable test for psychogenic erectile dysfunction. So they actually use the watching of pornography to see if someone has erectile dysfunction. One fascinating study identified that the brain activities of men watching pornography are not significantly different in men with and without erectile dysfunction. So that's some interesting counter studies there. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. ExpressCoin, the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency, whether you're going to spend your cryptocurrency on porn or on video games.
There is Girls Gone Bitcoin.
Is there now?
But no, okay. That's old.
Yeah, because I know I heard a few of them. I don't know how many of them are still around, but those things did exist. Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, you can get them from ExpressCoin.com. And of course, there's a lot of other stuff you can buy with Bitcoin as well. In fact, they're accepted by probably, I don't know, hundreds of thousands of people around the world, if not millions. of them, businesses, and all kinds. They're licensed money services business over at expresscoin.com, and they will hook you up. When you send them a money order or a check, they'll send Bitcoin to your Bitcoin wallet, and whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you. Just start off at expresscoin.com. You can grab their smartphone app at expresscoin.com and use coupon code FTL when you order to get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice with no transfer fee at all. So go to expresscoin.com and use coupon code FTL. As we go to your calls and thoughts, we've got Edward in Battle Creek, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live, listening to WBCK. Hey, Edward.
Hello, gentlemen. How are you doing this evening?
Good, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
I listened to the gentleman speaking ahead of me, and some thoughts have come to mind. I would like to get your, I guess, perspective on them.
Yes, please.
Sex is a wonderful thing some would say designed, if one believes in a designer, for one man and one woman, for the purpose of a commitment, and within that commitment, being able to celebrate that commitment with physical intimacy. That being said, when you look at pornography and the fake, the counterfeit form of it that it is, can there ever be considered a good reason for that?
What's the question? Can there be a good reason to look at pornography given that it is not emulative of what your belief around sex is?
Correct.
So one of the euphemisms for pornography and other things that that one buys in the naughty store is marital aid. So I would go ahead and say, sure. If we're going to talk biblical stuff, the marriage bed is undefiled, and therefore a husband and wife who, you know, for whatever reason, wish to watch pornography together in order to enhance their sex life, why not?
Do you believe a woman ever feels secure after the husband needs to look at another woman?
I've never been a woman. I wouldn't know.
You do understand that there are women who look at pornography as well, right?
The numbers would probably indicate, since men are, and studies would bear it out, men are very visually driven, where women are not. They're
I've heard that that's the case, but I don't know if that's actually true.
Yeah, I think that there are studies that counter that old claim, the whole men are from Venus, men are from Mars, women are from Venus standpoint. I don't know whether I even believe that statement anymore. But I would say that men probably more dependent on porn than women are.
I think that's true.
But you're asking me to extrapolate, and I can't do it. I would be willing to say, son, you asked me to come up with a circumstance, and I came up with a circumstance. So I'm going to go out and say a little bit further that yes, there are women, wives out there that can watch porn and still be secure in their marriage. Sure.
In your job setting, you encounter quite a few men, and probably some of them have spoken of their use of porn. How many men or how many women have you heard that would have ever discussed?
Usually men and women don't have those conversations, but I have had conversations with women about their porn use. But when the sex is, look, I'm a heterosexual male. When a woman begins talking to me about her porn use, it's tantamount to flirting with me and asking me to have sex with her.
And when a man brings it up, does it automatically display his dependency, his need to have an aid in his sexual experience?
No, it doesn't. It doesn't display that at all.
Then what would be the reason for it? If you held it up as a marital aid, the gentleman calling before had held it up as an aid of sorts. What's the purpose of porn then, really?
I would say it's an enhancement. You get to see the stuff rather than imagining it.
Well, I think it's, I think it does come back to the fact that, at least in the United States, there's a big Puritan influence in our past. And I think that results in not just an obsession with pornography, but just an obsession with sex and various sort of deviancies, if you will. But ultimately, people are fascinated by sex, and porn allows them to, for whatever reason, porn allows them to explore that fascination in areas in which they don't feel comfortable enough to go on their own, you know, perhaps into kink or fetish that they don't feel comfortable with, or they wouldn't know where to begin going to connect with people like that. Obviously, the internet now makes this more possible than ever before, so if you're looking for kinky fetish people, it's not as hard to find them as previous. But, it gives you the opportunity to quietly explore sexuality without ever having to talk to anyone about it. And I imagine that given that we're essentially told that sex is bad, that would be why people don't like talking about those things. At least
whoever said sex was bad.
There's a lot of pop culture out there.
Yeah,
and
I think
religion.
I was told that as I was growing up. I would definitely got the impression that sex was for men and women did it in order to make their husbands feel better. I definitely got that impression. I was raised in a Christian home. My mother was a Sunday school teacher, and I went to a private school, a private Christian school. So, yes, I'm going to say that that occurred for me.
That's unfortunate that someone would speak of something so wonderful.
Oh, it is. Very unfortunate, and I agree with you there. Thank you, Edward.
It's a short step from premarital sex is dirty to sex is dirty, right? Like,
yeah.
If you tell a kid sex is bad until you get into the marriage bed, you have to really sort of explain why it is that you believe that and what the values are that surround it.
Well, but even within the context of the marriage bed, aren't there certain beliefs out there, Mark, that believe that sex outside of the missionary position is bad, right? Like, you know, doggy style is bad, even if you are married. I'm sure there's certain religions who believe that, right?
Well, different. This is the thing, is you're going to have as many different opinions on this as you have people who are believers. And, I think that it is incredibly healthy. But you have to start with the premise that we were created and this particular book is the right book that tells us about this stuff. And all the other religious momentum that for the last 2,000 years, all that stuff's correct, because the Bible doesn't spend that much time talking about sex, so people come to the conclusions they come to. I mean, if you look at science, and you look at bonobos and how they behave, scientists have posited that the reason that women make noise during sex and men tend not to is in order to call the other men to come have sex with them sort of when they're ready. Like they're in, their prime, it's time to have sex.
Really?
So that you're drawing more there. So, that's the reason that so many sperm are released, so that they can compete against other sperm that are released by other males in the immediate time frame.
I didn't know it was true that men are less likely to be noisy than women. Is it a significant percentage less?
Look, I've only read this stuff. Yeah. I don't know what to believe or what not to believe. I mean, who knows?
Because, I mean, if going by that belief...
I think half of science is faith.
Right. Well, the man being noisy could be to scare the other men off from coming around. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts with us.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Hi, John Huebner from Midas Resources. Are you tired of watching your hard-earned assets dwindle away? As government spending is out of hand and the Federal Reserve is creating in excess of $20 billion a week, are you tired of stockbrokers gambling away your hard-earned money? Is this market a setup for a crash greater than 1987? Too many of today's policies resemble those that led to the collapse of 1929.
This is John Huebner, and that was me in 2007. And we all know what happened when the subprime credit bubble burst. By March 2009, the dollar lost 50% of its value. The entire U.S. banking system was on the verge of collapsing. Like all financial problems of the past, is history about to repeat itself? Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 129, before it's too late to protect yourself. Will the oncoming catastrophe take all private IRAs, 401ks with it? There is a way to protect your hard-earned assets. Call me, John Huebner, at 1-800-686-2237. 6-2-2-3-7, extension 129.
Free Talk Live.
I did all this construction. Well, I had the inspector come through, and he tells me it looks really good, but I think it looks better with Mr. Hamilton. I go, excuse me? He grabs a sledgehammer, and he just starts tearing the place apart. He says it'd be better with Mr. Hamilton. He was looking for payoff.
A $10 bill?
The guy was crazy. He went into my kitchen, and he asked for Mr. Lincoln.
I don't think I believe you.
My mother left me a porcelain doll collection that he just went to town on. this is the problem with having to have inspections.
Thanks for the call, man.
No, that was believable at the very first point.
The guy was asking for Mr. Hamilton.
How about Mr.
Alexander
Franklin?
Hamilton is on the front of a $10 bill. I mean, I'm like, holy crap, he's banging holes in the wall for $10 bill.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free to join us here on the live Saturday edition of the program. Our number, 855-450-FREE. We're talking about addiction to pornography and video games, something that is affecting, according to Phil Zimbardo from Stanford, you might know him from the Stanford Prison Experiment, he's saying this is a crisis for young males and maybe some females as well, but he's focusing on males. The book that he's putting out there, and I'm sure hoping that you'll buy a copy of, is called Man Disconnected. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We would like you to connect with us and tell us your story. Share your experience with addiction to video games or pornography, or both, is what he's saying the problem is. And we'll continue taking your calls and thoughts here. I want to also remind you that our African Satellite fundraiser is continuing for less than two more days. We're at around, I think, 30-something hours left at this point. And you can contribute to getting the ideas of liberty and freedom on the air in Africa on free-to-air satellite, which is broadcast to millions of potential homes that could listen to our content and the content you hear over at LRN.FM. And that will cost around $22,000 for a three-year contract. We're looking to raise as much as possible to get the ball rolling on this. And so far, our listeners have come through with a few thousand bucks, and I appreciate that. There's perks available. You can go to africa.lrn.fm. If you've been waiting until the last minute, we're pretty much there. I got less than just over a day remaining in this thing. So the end of the weekend, we'll pretty much wrap it up. Go to africa.lrn.fm, and thank you in advance for helping us do that. That's africa.lrn.fm. And don't worry if we don't meet the goal. We're not going to, unless some big money angel flies in here at the very end. We'll still get to keep like 91% of what we raise, even if we don't meet the goal, which is one of the nice things about Indiegogo compared to Kickstarter. Kickstarter means you have to get to the goal to get the money.
Okay.
Indiegogo will allow you to set your fundraiser up to where no matter what amount you raise, you get to keep most of it, the supermajority of it. So if we were to make our goal, they would keep less of a percentage. I think they'd keep 4%, but they'll keep 9% if we don't make the goal. So please do give over at africa.lrn.fm. Let's go to Will. He's in Hampton, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hi, Will.
Hey, how you doing?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Well, good. Well, you know, I appreciate the topic of your conversation this evening, but in my opinion, I think that people with sex addictions or video addictions need to go see a therapist.
Now, is porn the same thing as a sex addiction? I don't think it quite is.
Well, no, I don't think it's quite the same, but I think that there are some similarities.
I'd agree.
Well, I would say anyone with an addiction to something should probably seek
exactly.
some help for it, right?
Exactly.
I mean, the definition of an addiction is something that some kind of a habit that has gone too far and is causing problems, right?
And it's progressing.
Exactly. So that's all I really want to say. I think you guys are really doing a good job, and thank you very much.
Thanks for being out there, Will. Appreciate your call. Straight Razor's on the line in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live, Straight Razor.
Good evening, gentlemen. I feel kind of bad after hearing the Africa commercial. However, I was calling about the getting the show. I noticed that you guys have an iHeart account.
That's
but
right.
It's not. But where I'm at, it's
Wait,
not
it's
showing
not what?
The. It's not showing like the live stuff that's happening. Like it's
live
not a
stuff.
Live broadcast.
Right. Yeah. Our iHeart Radio entry is only the podcast. We actually have two on iHeart Radio. There's one that's kind of like a little sampler where it gives you the last segment of each show every night. And then there's a Free Talk Live full show podcast through iHeart Radio. They don't have a live stream for Free Talk Live, but there are radio stations that air our show live that you can tune through iHeart Radio. That that would be one way for you to listen. But there are a bunch of apps out there that will tune our streams directly. If you are using Android, are you using Android or iPhone?
I'm using Android, so I'm actually using TuneIn most of the time to listen.
TuneIn's awesome. They do a great job of connecting you with thousands of online streams, and the Free Talk Live 24/7 stream is on TuneIn, so you can listen to Free Talk Live anytime via live streaming there. Of course, when we're live, and then the other 21 hours, you hear the latest show repeated over and over again. And then also the LRN.FM stream is also available via TuneIn. So TuneIn is probably the easiest kind of plug-and-play method of getting to those streams. I'm sorry, but iHeartRadio doesn't have it. I've been in talks with them about adding LRN.FM, and that might progress at some point in the future, but there's a technical difficulty on their end that won't allow that to be the case anytime soon.
Okay, that's what I was asking about. Is there anything that we can do to kind of help that? Because I like TuneIn. The problem is, though, it's choppy if you're moving in and out of Wi-Fi, and iHeart seems to handle that better.
Huh.
But as far as the topic that we have going with addiction, being in my line of work, I take psychology very seriously to mitigate many issues that I can come across.
You're a police officer, for listeners who are not familiar with you. Anyway, go ahead.
Yes, sir. Whether they're mentally ill or so, it helps me to recognize problems early on rather than getting into a confrontation with someone who isn't there.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the things that we studied was video games and why Americans are so attracted to them. And I think it kind of plays into both the porn conversation and the video game conversation is that most of the people who have come here were adventurous to begin with, because very little of the indigenous population is here. So most of us came from a migratory family, and that sense of adventure is something that video games or, like you said, adventurous porn can give us that we can't really seek anymore. There's not unfounded lands for us to just go discover.
I don't know. That seems like a stretch. I mean, video games are popular the world around.
Well, I think when you're looking at games like Civilization and these kind of things, sure, I think it taps into that exploring spirit. So I'm willing to listen a little bit more.
Yeah, but who's to say that the American kids today have that exploring spirit? That doesn't make any sense.
I think it's in people's DNA. He's just proposing that it's more so in American DNA because this is a population of people who came here.
But they came here from other countries, so wouldn't those same people be in other countries as well?
No, they wouldn't. They left those countries.
Well, the thing is that you're looking at a population that instead of staying in that foreign country, they actually made the decision and shift that. It's kind of like everyone who's moving up to, Keene or participating in the Free State Project. Mm-hmm. They're going to be generally more open to adventure than a lot of people are. So I definitely think that it has something to do with where you come from.
Interesting speculation, Straight Razor. Thanks for the call tonight. And of course, Mark, you are. How many video games do you have open right now?
None.
Oh, yeah? I see one right there on your phone.
Oh, yep. I got one open.
You are not supposed to be playing.
I'm not playing.
I know you weren't playing yet. I'm giving you a hard time.
The phone just opened. You know, yeah. It just
sometimes I bust for new listeners to the show. Sometimes I'll bust Mark playing video games during the show, and that is a no-no. He's
yeah,
being
I don't
a naughty
think
boy when
it,
he does
it's been
that.
Many years. It's been
no,
some
it hasn't
years.
Been years. It's probably been a few weeks
since you busted me.
Yeah,
I don't think so.
I'll see it reflected in your eyeglasses
Can
sometimes.
You see?
No, I can't see it right now.
You see Facebook?
I don't know. I can't tell what it is. All right, Randy's with us in Kalamazoo, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Randy.
Hi, how's it going?
We're doing a radio show. It's great. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just called in regard to the struggle with addiction that you guys are talking about. And I know that the previous caller, the police officer, was talking about, you know, the addiction to video games, addiction to pornography. And to kind of counteract what you guys were saying about, you know, well, this is a problem world over. And I think that's absolutely correct. And I think that as a society, we have desensitized ourselves to the fact that there are so many things available at the tips of our fingers. We have internet on our phones. We have internet on our tablets. Heck, we have internet in our cars these days.
Mm-hmm.
And,
yep.
You know, for video games and for everything, there's nothing. There's no filter that's stopping us from getting these things. And I think, especially in America, you know, we see this in the media. We see this all over the place about sexual assault. We see all these things about molestations and things that are just running so rampant within our society that we've lost a grip. We've started to accept this as, oh, well, that's commonplace. And unfortunately, that is not true.
We just
that
had a psychiatrist or psychologist, I'm not sure which one
he
was.
He said he was psychologist.
Psychologist on the beginning of last hour, or this hour, I'm not sure, recently in the last few segments, who said that when porn, that they did a study, and when porn stores would open in a given neighborhood, sexual assaults would go down.
Well, I guess it kind of feeds their desire to explore a sexual desire that they've had in the past, that now they are exhibiting it with things they can buy versus things they can take.
I'd call that preferable.
Yeah, absolutely. Regardless, I'm not justifying the fact that there are porn stores everywhere, or that where cases of sexual assault pop up. Hey, let's put a porn store there. That's not going to solve the problem. Regardless, we have taken the act of sex, and we have determined it, and we have created it into a worldly thing where it's not just between man and woman. It's not just between people who love each other. It's now running rampant.
Man and machine. Thanks for the call, Randy. More coming up here. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Times sure have changed since Geico started saving people money over 75 years ago. We didn't have video games like today, but that's not to say we didn't have fun. One of my favorite games was Don't Get Kicked by the Goat. Now that's some real excitement, especially when someone lost. Yep, back then we knew two things, how to have a good time, and that Geico was always a good deal.
Geico, saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years.
The results are in. For the treatment of nasal allergy symptoms, nothing is more effective than Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of the worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. And in a recent clinical study with Nasacort going nose-to-nose with Flonase, more people prefer Nasacort. For more information, visit Nasacort.com. Nasacort. Use as directed.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.50 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $240. Antiwar.com reports the Senate Armed Services Committee has unveiled a version of the annual military spending bill that will provide a pathway for the closure of the detention center at Guantanamo Bay. The bill includes certain restrictions on transfers of detainees, but mandates the Defense Department to detail a case-by-case plan of disposition for all remaining detainees. Senate officials say the agreement was a bipartisan compromise on the matter, though some, including Senator James Inhofe of Oklahoma, said they were deeply disappointed with any deal to close the site. Even if it passes the Senate, it will set the stage for a major fight with the House of Representatives, whose version of the funding bill not only does not contain provisions on closing Gitmo, but includes several new restrictions above and beyond those already in place. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports a proposed rule by the U.S. Department of Education seeks to prevent colleges and banks from pushing accounts with high fees on students. The department said the regulations would give students greater choice in how they receive refunds from their student aid after college tuition and fees are paid. As it stands now, some colleges have entered into agreements with banks to outsource the distribution of those refunds through debit accounts or prepaid cards in exchange for financial considerations. Students are often enticed to choose these accounts, which often have high overdraft fees because they may receive their refunds faster this way, according to the Department of Education. Under the proposed regulation, students would not be required to open a certain account in order to receive refunds. Banks assisting colleges with payments of refunds would be required to ensure students aren't charged overdraft fees. Institutions must provide a list of account options to students. Colleges must ensure that payments made to students' pre-existing accounts must be made within the same time frame as those to bank accounts marketed by the college. Consumer Banker Association President and CEO Richard Hunt criticized the proposed regulations, saying it will ultimately cost students more money. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports bullying in U.S. schools fell to a record low in 2013, with 22% of students reporting being bullied, according to the U.S. Department of Education. The figure had hovered at 28% or higher in biennial student surveys since 2005, according to the department. The number is based on school crime data for students aged 12 to 18 compiled by the Justice Department. Education Secretary Arne Duncan and Health and Human Services Secretary Sylvia Burwell called the drop welcome news after campaigns in recent years to tackle the problem. Burwell said in a statement, "Parents, teachers, health providers, community members, and young people are clearly making a difference by taking action and sending the message that bullying is not acceptable." The drop in bullying was seen across various groups. In 2013, about 24% of female students reported being bullied at school, down from as high as 1 out of every 3. 19% of male students said they had been bullied, down from a high of 32% in 2007. Bullying is more common in lower grades, with 28% of 6th graders and 23% of 9th graders reporting being bullied. The figure drops to 14% for high school seniors. The figures are based on a poll of 4,942 students done for the School Crime Supplement to the Justice Department's National Crime Victimization Survey. The Education Department said there were three types of bullying: physical, social, and verbal. Students who are bullied are more likely to struggle in school and skip class. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Now, how much money will all those closeted Republican convention goers bring into the city, Marie?
A lot. The average area prostitute normally makes around $200 to $300 a week jerking off truck drivers behind the bus station.
I see.
Next week, they are expecting to make 30 times that amount sucking off secretly gay Republicans.
Wow.
You figure the fact that these delegates are so repressed and filled with self-hatred,
yes,
they tend to like the filthiest, kinkiest sex acts imaginable.
Oh, that's
which
right.
Tends to cost more. The average well-adjusted gay man has no desire to smear fecal matter all over his partner. Face
no.
Or be beat up by him. But that is exactly the sort of thing that these repressed conservatives are willing to pay top dollar for.
Okay, as well as the services of transsexuals, I understand.
Yes. A lot of the Republicans repeatedly call the prostitutes faggots or start crying after they've had sex with them.
I suppose the prostitutes are shoring up on their politics so they can talk to the Republicans.
Ha ha, Andrea, what do you think this is, Pretty Woman? They're just there to get
right. Thank you, Marie Byron.
Oh, RNC's always a good time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, it's Ian here.
And Mark.
We've got Skype as well. Nobody on Skype yet tonight. Skype username's lrn.fm. Phones have been blowing up, though. So if you want to sound better than the average caller, call us on Skype. Just send a contact request over to lrn.fm. We'll approve it, and then from that point on, it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype. We're here live on the Live Saturday edition. We've been talking about a new book, which neither of us have read, but there's news about it. There's news about it. It's called Man Disconnected by Philip Zimbardo. Now, that is a name that longtime listeners of Free Talk Live will probably recognize from the Stanford prison experiment.
It immediately has currency with me simply because of that.
Because of that. Yeah, exactly. This guy's a great researcher. He's done a lot of interesting work over the years, especially in the realm of authority and people's roles in society. That's what the Stanford prison experiment delved into. Now he's looking into the world of the young male. He, in fact, studied 20,000 of them. Now, that's a pretty big study. It's a lot bigger than the Stanford prison experiment.
Sure is. That is not a small end tab.
Found that they are playing video games and watching pornography in their downtime from playing video games.
What a surprise. I hope we got to spend a lot of government money on that.
He says it's a crisis, and it is about – it's a problem with young men's masculinity that essentially – there have been a variety of sort of societal causes of this, but basically that young men are being emasculated by these video games and pornography. But some of our callers tonight have said that's not the case. We had one psychologist call in. So, you know, one psychologist's opinion versus another. Another psychologist called in tonight to say that this is not a problem. If people are doing something that they enjoy, why should they be punished for that? Why should they, you know, be looked down upon
for that? I suspect Zimbardo is a psychiatrist, and I don't really remember what Dave said he was.
I don't
was.
Think so. Psychiatrist is somebody who prescribes medication.
Yep.
I don't know if he's a psychiatrist. I've not ever heard him described that way. It describes him here in the article as a psychologist.
Okay.
So, anyway, the other psychologist who called the show tonight said this isn't a big deal. What's the problem here? Well, I think that like any addiction, it can be a problem. I mean, if you are spending 15 hours a day, as they cite one young man in this particular experiment, admitting that he spends up to 15 hours in a day playing video games and says he doesn't think he has a problem, there's a problem there. You know, you don't have enough time. If you are playing 15 hours of video games, I don't know if it's ever an everyday thing, but even so often, it's going to be a problem. It's going to affect your sleep ability. It's going to affect your ability to earn
earning potential.
And it's going to affect your ability to have and keep a mate around as well. I'm going to share with you the remainder of the story here. Zimbardo says better sex education is necessary, which should focus on biology and safety as well as emotions, physical contact, and romantic relationships. I just can't even imagine how ridiculously laughable the already bad government sex education would become if they started trying to inculcate the youth with lessons about romance and, you know, emotions. He says the article over at theindependent.co.uk, the pressing issue of male mental health is now a much more prominent concern than it once was. Last year saw the first male psychology conference at the University College of London, intended to encourage the British Psychological Society to introduce a male specialist section to sit alongside its female equivalent. The charity Campaign Against Living Miserably, or CALM, was started in 2006 and has gained a high profile in recent years for its efforts to encourage men to discuss mental health problems and bring down the male suicide rate. Of course, Zimbardo is famous for his 1971 Stanford prison experiment, in which 24 students were asked to play the roles of guards and prisoners in a mock prison at Stanford University, intended to last for 2 weeks. The experiment was abandoned after just 6 days, after the previously normal guards became extremely sadistic and the prisoners became submissive and depressed. The experiment is believed to demonstrate the extreme impressionability and obedience of people when they're presented with a supporting ideology and power. Let's go and talk to you. James is in Kalamazoo, Michigan, listening via TuneIn. Hey, James.
Hello. I guess Kalamazoo is getting some good representation tonight.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Via the callers. Actually, I wanted to talk about a childhood friend of mine, and he had kind of an issue with pornography addiction, and then he got into a relationship and continued that.
When you say kind of an addiction, what are we talking about? Do you have any idea?
Well, he watched it every day. I mean, It was
multiple times a day.
I'm assuming. I didn't ask him. You know, I just kind of took his word for it.
Yeah, I imagine a lot of guys don't really go into great detail about their porn addictions with one another.
Yeah, I mean, I just kind of took his word for it.
Okay.
He was, you know, trying to convert me to his church. And, apparently he got into a relationship with a woman and actually had issues because, as he explained it to me, what he viewed as reality wasn't happening. Essentially, he could not get the same thing from his own sexual encounters than he did from the desires from watching the pornography.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, where he said that he dealt with it. And I'm talking somebody in his mid-20s that should be, you know, essentially not having these issues, but essentially, he'd been numbed so much or whatever, to where he could not perform once he got with a partner because the actual act of doing it wasn't anywhere close to the act of that he saw on the screen.
Now, this is very similar to a call we had earlier tonight, which essentially expressed the same viewpoint. But the psychology studies here are not showing any correlation to watching porn or having a porn addiction and having, you know, an issue with erections. There's just no real evidence for that. In fact, there's actually evidence to the contrary.
But the way they study it is by having people watch porn. And I think that that's a sort of a fallacious way to go about it. Do you get what I'm saying?
I can see both sides of the argument because I've been in relationships myself, an ex-marriage where, you know, we kind of went through, a dry spell, and we actually used the viewing of pornography to kind of enhance the experience.
Hmm.
They don't call it a marital aid for nothing.
So you had the opposite effect then. So you used pornography as a tool to make your sex life better.
Yeah, absolutely. And it actually really worked. You know, we ended up splitting up for different reasons, but it actually did help. I'm just stating that there might be an argument for the other side because,
right.
I've heard this also talking to other people. I'm not saying that it's common, but I think it has more to do with the state of mind
yes.
than the actual act of watching the pornography.
I think you're absolutely right about that, James. Thanks for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450. Free.
Well, most people have been calling in and talking about sort of moderation regarding this. And, human beings are just the sorts that they can abuse just about anything that makes them feel good. And that's just that. And I don't really know how to address that. Like, I can't stop humans from being humans.
So a little more about the studies. I'm going to bring back to the Psychology Today, which took a look and found that they looked at what was some sort of a search tool, basically, for psychological studies called PubMed. It's the largest online database of medical literature. and they could not find a single study that links pornography with erectile dysfunction. They found 52 publications, and the bulk of those are studies that use pornography to test erectile dysfunction.
Yeah.
And two compelling recent studies discuss high rates of erectile dysfunction among young men. A 2013 study by Capogrosso found that 25% of men seeking treatment for first-onset erectile dysfunction were under the age of 40 and characterized these high rates as worrisome. A 2012 study by Myelon identified that 30% of young Swiss men reported a history of erectile dysfunction, though the majority of these reports were classified as mild ED. This study is remarkable in that it represents a valid snapshot of the population of all young Swiss men, given that the research involved over 9,000 men reporting for nationally required universal medical screening to determine military capacity. Both of the studies identify there's very little existing research that examines the rates of ED in young men, and I'll tell you more about it here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. What is causing the erectile dysfunction? We'll tell you what the studies say in a moment.
Are you living with pain? So was Lisa, a brave Marine wounded in Iraq.
After surviving an explosion, I was on horrible painkillers. I tried 1 hour pain relief, and now I'm pain-free all day without dangerous side effects. And it works in less than 1 hour.
Try it free for 1 week and pay only the shipping with no automatic shipments. Call 800-400-3610 right now or visit onehourpainrelief.com. That's 800-400-3610. 800-400-3610.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State. Or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us here on the air at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, you've got Ian here.
And Mark.
And I want to let you know about the Next Issue app. Perhaps you've not heard of Next Issue. Well, it is, I have to say, it was new to me. And I think it's pretty cool. It's like Netflix for magazines. You can get access to over 150 of some of the most popular magazines out there. You know, probably if you name it, it's likely going to be in Next Issue. ESPN, Sports Illustrated, Men's Health, Maxim, Esquire, Entertainment Weekly, People. I mean, I could go on, but there's 150, so
it's a huge opportunity to save if you're, a magazine reader. If you've got two subscriptions, man, cancel them and do this.
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, if you go to the newsstand and you buy two magazines, you will likely more than cover the cost of 1 month subscription to Next Issue. In fact, you get your first month for free just for trying it out over at nextissue.com/FTL. So it's a $15 savings. There's actually a $9.99 plan per month as well as a $15 plan. You can go and learn more over at nextissue.com/FTL. It works on the most popular devices, whether it's iPad, iPhone, Android tablets, and smartphones. You can go and try it out for yourself. It's a free 30-day trial, no commitments, cancel anytime. Your favorite magazines, and probably some you've never really felt like paying for, but might have been
now
curious.
Now you got it.
Yeah, might have been curious to know what the content was. Now it's there, and you'll get updates as far as, you know, it'll let you know on your notifications when a new issue's out. So the latest issue of Entertainment Weekly just came out. I was looking at it a few moments ago. They've got an interview with the Game of Thrones star Maisie Williams. I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce her name, but she's very, very popular. It's a very popular show, and I've seen a couple of the episodes of the Game of Thrones. I did enjoy it. Maybe at some point I'll pick it up again. But go ahead and pick up your favorite magazine in digital form via nextissue.com/FTL. Go there now to get your free trial started and get a month for free. nextissue.com/FTL. You can sign up today. We're talking about pornography and video games, and the addiction, apparently, that is fairly common amongst young males in the United States and other Western nations, according to a recent study of approximately 20,000 participants of young males. And Phil Zimbardo is behind this one. He's the guy who was also behind the infamous Stanford prison experiment. I was sharing with you a little bit more information about some of the counter information to what Zimbardo is saying. Zimbardo was suggesting that there's a problem with erectile dysfunction affecting these young males. They should be virile, but they're not, because of their addictions to pornography. But the scientific studies, psychological studies, are suggesting that's not necessarily the case. In fact, there is no... The Psychology Today did a search, and they could not find any study that links together the viewing of pornography and erectile dysfunction. But further, they did find studies that do show that young males are having issues with erectile dysfunction. Now, society, according to Psychology Today, has undergone a dramatic shift in the past years as medications for ED have become more widely available. Since 1999, when Bob Dole appeared in commercials for Viagra, there appears to have been a decrease in the stigma associated with disclosing erectile dysfunction. The high numbers of disclosure of erectile dysfunction in young men may reflect this change and not an increase in the rates that are actually experienced. But
well, I'd also like to point out when we're talking about medication that there are plenty of medications out there now that are in a far larger proliferation that cause erectile dysfunction too.
Well, right, and they touch on that here. So what do the study authors blame these high rates of erectile dysfunction in young men? The answer is not pornography. In fact, pornography use doesn't come up in either of these studies, nor in any of the reports of the young men. The study's authors found that young men's erectile dysfunction was linked to the use of medication without a prescription, to a low level of sexual experience, and to both mental and physical health. Tobacco use, alcohol use, and drug use were also significant predictors. So young men are having erectile problems when they drink too damn much.
You know, if life isn't fulfilling, people are going to escape. And, you know, it's, the economy's been rough on young men.
Let's talk to Jeremy. He's in Central Virginia, I think listening to WLNI in Lynchburg. Hey, Jeremy. Jeremy? In Virginia.
Yep, can you hear me?
Hey, we've got you. Go ahead.
Great. I just had a quick anecdote. I was going to see if I could spell over the air.
Sure.
I was dating an older woman about two years back, and she was married at one point, only married once, no kids, and she got divorced. And she had alluded to her husband's addiction as to the reason that they got divorced, and we only dated for a short period.
His what addiction? Porn addiction?
Well, that's where I didn't dig into it until she mentioned it another time, and so... because I didn't want to pry. We were, you know, it was a short relationship. And so I asked her, well, what was your husband addicted to? She said, well, he was addicted to porn. And I turned to her and I looked at her and I said, porn is not an addiction. Cocaine is an addiction. And that was pretty much the end of the relationship.
Why do you believe that porn is not an addiction?
I just believe, like, a lot of things that it's one of those things where it's easily controlled and
maybe for you
moderation kind of thing.
I was talking to my wife, who is actually went to college for addictions. She's an addiction specialist, and I have held the same opinion that you have currently, or at least you expressed in your past. And she made it very, very concise for me. She's said that physical addiction's nothing compared to psychological addiction. She can take somebody and detox them in 72 hours and they're no longer facing their physical addiction. The rest of it is simply their psychological addiction that you're dealing with. And this, as succinctly as she was able to put it, changed my mind completely in an instant.
Mm-hmm. I was referring to more of the physical addiction part.
Yeah, I mean, you know, because I used to say, it's not an addiction unless it's a physical addiction. But,
right.
You know, I've met people that claim that this pornography addiction, I can't understand why somebody would want to watch pornography when they weren't doing the deed. You know what I mean? The singular deed, as it were. So, right. But I mean, as I understand it, some people will sit there and watch that stuff for entertainment, you know, this bad acting and God knows what else. Maybe they got the sound off. I don't know what they're doing.
Do you remember the story about Belle Knox, the libertarian porn star girl? The guy who, I think it was her story where the guy who outed her as a porn star, they found somebody who was running a porn site found his account on their porn site and released the information that this guy was a customer. And revealed that he had spent $1,000. I don't know if it was per month or what it was, but it was a lot of money. He spent a lot of money on porn. So even though he could get free pornography, he was still paying like an addictive level of payment to continue to consume porn from these websites. If your habit is hurting you, that's an addiction. If it's damaging your ability to have a productive lifestyle, to get to work on time, to keep a job, to keep a relationship moving forward, then it is an addiction. Now, maybe, Jeremy, you've got it under control, but for some people, they definitely don't. And thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you want to share your story of, and it's been mostly porn tonight, but video game addiction is also pretty profound. Some would say even more damaging because there's no orgasm with a video game. It's Free Talk Live.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per
caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your four-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We've got time for you. If you want to dial in and join us here on the live Saturday edition of the program, our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. And if you like Free Talk Live and you want to help support what we're doing on the radio wave, spreading the message of freedom and liberty around the globe, you can become an amplifier for $5 a month. You'll get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, AMP-only Facebook group, and more. Go get the details, and please get signed up. It makes a real big difference for us when you do that because it allows us to market the show more effectively to more radio stations. We're on over 150 stations today, which makes us the number one most distributed internet-based, radio-based show. Like, we're the premier liberty-oriented show. But we could be on 300. We could be on 400. It just takes money and time to get the word out to stations that we exist and that we've been around for a while now. So we've actually been doing this show for over a decade, and you can help us get on more stations by joining the AMP program and getting perks for yourself as well. amp.freetalklive.com. AMP, like advertise, market, and promote. AMP. www.freetalklive.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We're talking about video game and porn addictions. Most of the calls have focused on the porn aspect of this, but in a way, video game addiction, I think, could be even more profound. I mean, we've talked to people who've had addictions with pornography. They've known people who've had addictions with pornography. They would look at porn on a daily basis, perhaps more than once per day. But I don't know how often a porn addict is going to spend 15 hours in a stretch looking at porn. I'm not saying it's not done. I imagine it is done. But it would seem more likely to me, at least, and maybe I'm just putting my own values onto this, but it seems more likely that between the two addictions, video game addiction is going to suck away more hours.
More time, and that's your most valuable resource anyway.
Right, and so if you're playing a video game, especially one of these massively multiplayer online role-playing games, which are hugely addictive and never-ending, then the satisfaction that you would get from, say, orgasming doesn't happen with a video game. Yeah, you might get up to the next level, right? Like in one of these RPGs, you gain levels, you gain experience over time. It's satisfying to see your character go from level 2 to level 3 or level 30 to 31, but the level of satisfaction there isn't on the level of an orgasm, right?
Okay, I'm not going to agree or disagree with that. What I'm going to say is that video games have become very good at sort of tapping into that portion of your brain that likes achievement.
Yeah,
and
they even have achievements.
They call
games.
It achievements, right. I wish they didn't, because then I could describe this better. You want to achieve things, and life achieving things is a little slower than generally than it is in a video game. You can, you know, sign up with a World of Warcraft account, and by the end of the day, I would guess, I'm just taking a poke at this, you can probably be level 10 or 15
probably
or something like that. You know, you probably dedicate a good portion of the day to doing it,
right.
And that's a pretty high level of achievement. If you go from level 1 to level 15 talk show host, you're not going to do that in one day. You're probably not going to do that in one year.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know what a level 15 talk show host sounds like. Maybe I'm higher, maybe I'm lower. I don't know what the answer is. But these video games are they take life and they kind of speed it up, and they give you this sense of achievement. So that can be just as rewarding, even more so addictive than pornography. I'd say the pornographic addiction really comes into play when you're in a committed relationship and your partner begins to feel unfulfilled.
Yeah.
And that happens, and it's even more damaging than video games at that point.
Let's go to Charlie. He's in the Indianapolis area listening to WIBC. Hey, Charlie.
Good evening.
Hey, go ahead.
Okay. I missed bits and pieces of the program as the reception in this area is not really great, but I've got kind of a different take on this. I'm a middle-aged man and have had problems with ED for years and complicated by Peyronie's. And so there is no relationship of a sexual nature of any type. And generally, the pornography is used for a singular purpose. And at some points, that is physically the only way by using that to achieve satisfaction.
So wait, just to be clear, the issues you had weren't because of porn. You're using porn as a way to overcome those issues?
It doesn't ever actually overcome it. It just kind of compensates for it a bit because there is, basically no satisfactory compensation other than, just working through it, unfortunately.
Hmm.
There you go.
Thanks for sharing your story, Charlie. Anything else you want to add to it?
Oh, that's about the size of it, but it is rather frustrating sometimes. Though that's, what it actually comes down to, that, you have to resort to those kind of things.
Thanks for the call. I appreciate your story. Let's talk to Don. He's in Kalamazoo. You're on Free Talk Live. Don.
Yeah, so I had been listening a little bit to the show, and, the pornography thing, from a relationship perspective, you're setting expectations that simply aren't warranted. You have young men who don't have any committed relationship, so they're watching pornography with women who don't act that way. In many cases, women that are, forced into pornography, or they don't have any parents or
nobody's forced into
them.
Pornography.
Yeah, I don't like that terminology.
The that's actually not true. Go to Eastern Europe.
Okay, if you're talking about sex slaves that are being, recorded against their will, okay. But if you're talking about the actresses, if you're talking about actresses in porn, which is the most commonly used,
they do get some from Eastern Europe. But
there's
plenty there. But so even aside from that, we could probably argue that for hours. But the expectations that you set by watching pornography are never going to happen in a real relationship. So as a young man who doesn't have a relationship, then you go into a relationship, you expect a woman to act a certain way. Right?
I think that it also causes women young women who consume porn at nearly the same levels to alter the way that they might be in relationships too. And I find that is disturbing as anything.
Look, I'm not defending porn addiction here or anything like that, but it is certainly true that there are a lot of people who create amateur pornography, which is essentially them trying to emulate the professional pornography within usually the confines of their relationship. So certainly there are a number of couples out there who are doing porn in their relationship.
Well, and ultimately, it's just that there's a design for us to be together in a committed relationship that's loving. And that's certainly not it by exploiting each other or watching other people being exploited.
Well, you said designed, and I think that that's it's really telling. Likely you're saying that God wants you to be with one woman, and that's the way he designed it. Is that right?
Well, we're either animals,
uh-huh,
right?
Yeah.
Or we've been created by God.
Okay, I'd say the evidence is.
You could be both.
There's only two ways to do it.
No, I don't think that's true necessarily. I think that everything was created by God, but I would say that the evidence is on the side that you're an animal. You share a great deal of DNA with chimpanzees, and God created a whole bunch of sperm to compete. One would assume to compete with other sperm, the strongest sperm survives, and that kind of thing. If God wanted one man and one woman, he could just have the guy, shoot out one good sperm and it would go there and take care of that egg and all the problems would be solved.
One could argue that if you believed anything other than the God of the Bible, I mean, if you believe in some deity out there, then sure, it could be whatever you want it to be. There's many people, including myself, that don't believe that. So, one of us will be right and one of us will be wrong.
Hey, Don, you didn't call earlier tonight, did you?
I did not.
Okay, thanks for the call. I appreciate hearing from you. Yep. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There is a one-call-per-night rule. I'm not saying Don broke it. I'm just saying, letting you know.
Now that you're mentioning.
Yep, one call per night. Let's talk to Chris in Tioga, North Dakota. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live listening to KTGO.
Yeah, I just wanted to comment on this.
Whoa, you're a little loud there, Chris.
Oh, all right.
You're a little better. Go ahead.
Yep.
America was founded on Christianity, and based on that, what should be the safest place in America?
Are you going to tell me a church? I don't know.
Oh,
a prison?
The womb.
The womb.
Okay.
Okay.
The safest place in America. And so what do we got in America now? And these guys that are all
unsafe wombs?
I don't want to take a quiz. I want you to tell me what you think. Hang on, Chris. We'll bring you back here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. We got time for you. Actually, no, we don't. If you're not on hold, you're not getting in tonight. But that's okay, because we do a live show 7 nights per week. So you can join us tomorrow night. And, of course, over at freetalklive.com. In the meantime, we're going to continue with those of you who are on hold. We'll get to your thoughts. We've been talking about video game and pornography addiction in young males specifically. The author of the Stanford Prison Experiment, Phil Zimbardo, is saying this is a crisis for young males who are, he says, being disconnected from their manliness by these addictions. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go right back into your calls and thoughts. I do want to let you know, though, if you want to help support Free Talk Live, you can shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. You enter Amazon through the links you'll find there, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. So go and get your shopping done at shop.freetalklive.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. Alan's in Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Alan.
Hey, how you doing this evening?
Welcome. Go ahead.
I was just calling in because I had, you know, I've always watched porn, I have to say, since I was like 14 years old. And for a long time, you know, it affected relationships. I had a girlfriend that chunked a computer in a pool.
Whoa.
Because of it. And now I'm with a girl that actually watches porn with me. And I see a lot of girls that get upset about their guys watching porn, and I feel like it adds to our relationship. And as I see things that on the porn, you know, you have like the freakier things.
Plenty of that.
I don't want to use any. You know, I always wanted a girl that had like explosive orgasm. Okay. You know what I mean?
Yep.
This is your preference? This is what you're looking for? You don't want a girl with
really
a job?
Like no, I like that too. I enjoy a girl that has a job. Don't get me wrong. And
all
my
right.
girl does. But in a sexual relationship, I enjoy a girl that, you know, can do that because there's no faking that.
Yep.
And you always see, you know, that's one of like the big porn things is an explosive
female
orgasm.
Are you talking about female ejaculation? Is that what you mean when you
yes.
say explosive? Okay, got it.
So I lived in Statesboro, Georgia, for 5 years and went to college at Georgia Southern. And, you know, I had girls in and out. And I finally found one that just fit everything that I wanted out of pornography.
So
and it was perfect.
Are you
congratulations,
guys,
you're a pervert.
Are you guys I'm curious, Alan, are you watching as much porn now with your new porn-friendly girlfriend as you had watched previously?
I would probably say yes.
And she is engaging in 100% of watching it with you?
No, of course not. I still have my own little personal time.
Mm-hmm. But she's likely to find it a fine thing. She's attracted to it. She's, you know, sexualized by it, that kind of thing.
Yeah, she likes it. I mean, she doesn't know that I watch it by myself all the time.
Well, that's something you should, be clear on relatively early in the relationship. It sounds to me like any woman who's in a relationship with you is unqualified to be, you know, is considering a relationship with you is unqualified if she can't handle the idea that you consume porn by yourself. Now, I would suggest this to that there's a lot of guys listening to me that that qualify that really should be doing this too. And, you know, this is what I did relatively early on in my relationship when, you know, I was trying to qualify my wife as to whether or not she needs to be around or not is, ask her. When you're talking to the woman, you talk to them about your real life and ask them questions about how they fit in. Because if they don't, they need that feedback mechanism. For one, I think that many women will find that, when they start running across lots of guys that consume porn, they're like, maybe I need to change this whole jealousy thing I've got around imaginary women on computers or whatever.
Yeah, I like the idea of a lady who understands that men are going to look at other women, and similarly, women are going to look at other men. I mean, look, we're animals. That's our attraction. We can't help it. You shouldn't get upset about it, right?
Right, and I feel like I should, or every guy should, find a girl that, you know, if whatever you watch, whatever type of porn that you watch, that you should find a girl that will fit your type of porn. I know that kind of sounds odd, but if you know, like...
There's got to be a Facebook page for it.
Hey, Alan, thanks for the call, man. I do appreciate your thoughts. Let's continue here. I got to apologize to Chris. I forgot about him. Chris in Tioga, you're back on. Now, what was the point you were driving at before, Chris? Because we don't have time to answer a bunch of your questions. You just got to get your points out.
Well, I don't have a bunch of questions. It's just the fact that we've lost America has lost as far as Christianity goes, because the safest place that used to be is not anymore, and that is the womb. And the liberals and the Democrats are promoting that, and
promoting what?
That's what it is, and promoting abortion.
Okay, so you are upset that abortion exists?
Yep.
Okay,
I am.
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Well, it ain't going anywhere, buddy. And if you try to outlaw it, then it'll just go underground into the black marketplace and become dangerous to the women who seek those services.
Well, if we're going to talk about it, I would say that
nope,
I consider.
We're not. But you can say something quickly if you like.
I consider abortion to be the ending of human life. However, I think the prohibition of it has already been tried, and something else needs to be brought to the table.
Yeah, try something with compassion. Let's go to Calvin in Madison, Wisconsin. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Calvin.
Thank you. Yeah, this is a very interesting topic because I have great experience with both. I'm reading your age group that you're talking about there, 25.
Mm-hmm.
Where it goes with pornography, for me, myself, you know, I probably would look at it where some women would consider it addiction or anything else. But it's, you know, 15 minutes at a time or so forth. And it's really, to me, it's more of a stress relief, or at night it's a way for you to clear your head and go to sleep. It's really a relief and a way to release, I guess.
Are we talking about pornography or video games here?
Pornography. Yeah. Video games is much more time than that. With video games, it's interesting, too, because I play lots of video games, those role-playing games that you're speaking of earlier.
The massively multiplayer online role-playing games?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So I could easily spend, and I have spent, you know, a whole entire day easily just in front of either a computer or a console.
What's your favorite game? What is the one that you are most addicted to?
I was addicted to World of Warcraft at one time.
You were?
That sounds to be pretty epic.
Yes. Yeah. So, and with that, though, it is sort of part of our culture as a younger group in society. And it is a way for us to socialize as well. Friends I have also play video games. Mm-hmm. We play video games together. It's a part of our social group.
You are together, but you're also not together, right? Like, you're not sitting in a LAN party near physically those people. They are probably somewhere in their own home, and you're in your home, correct?
Right, yes.
Are you talking over, like, a headset where you can hear their voices, or are you typing on a keyboard?
Yeah, so you can hear, you wear a headset, like a Bluetooth piece on your head, and mm-hmm. you can talk to each other and communicate and work together, you know. Other games like Call of Duty or first-person games.
Now,
like
you said you were
well.
Addicted to World of Warcraft. Are you no longer?
I am not.
Can you play it?
I just...
And not be addicted?
And put it down?
Yeah, and put it down?
I would say no, actually.
So you have cut yourself off, then, from this?
Yeah, I have. I spent too much time on it.
When did you realize you were having a problem?
Honestly, I've played video games since I can remember, and video games have always been a huge part of my life. And the way I look at it as well is many of those times when I was not playing video games, I would probably be watching TV or doing something else. That's
fair enough.
Yeah. Life is just things you do until you die in many cases. So,
exactly.
I mean, if you like the video game, I don't see a problem with it.
Exactly. And I would play a lot of time on it that other people consider is harmful or addicting. But in my opinion, it's not. It's just my entertainment and my relief.
Yeah. Well,
my relief and my fun.
Don't forget that life's really about the stories that you create to be able to tell at the nursing home. So create some great stories besides playing video games.
Hey, Calvin, good call, man. Thanks for sharing your own personal experience with us. I appreciate that. Nathan, you got the last 20 seconds in Texas. Go.
Yeah, I wanted to say why I don't buy Philip Zimbardo's his disapproval of video games at all, or anyone over 30 or 40 who criticizes the video games.
Why? 10 seconds.
They haven't played them, and they don't know anything about it.
Yeah, that would be an interesting question to ask Phil Zimbardo. Have you actually played a video game? Thanks, Nathan, for your call, and thanks for summing it up so quickly. I appreciate that, too. We'll be back tomorrow night for the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. And, boy, do we have a weird story to talk about tomorrow night. See you then.
Now,
are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.50 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $240. Antiwar.com reports the Senate Armed Services Committee has unveiled a version of the annual military spending bill that will provide a pathway for the closure of the detention center at Guantanamo Bay. The bill includes certain restrictions on transfers of detainees, but mandates the Defense Department to detail a case-by-case plan of disposition for all remaining detainees. Senate officials say the agreement was a bipartisan compromise on the matter, though some, including Senator James Inhofe of Oklahoma, said they were deeply disappointed with any deal to close the site. Even if it passes the Senate, it will set the stage for a major fight with the House of Representatives, whose version of the funding bill not only does not contain provisions on closing Gitmo, but includes several new restrictions above and beyond those already in place. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports a proposed rule by the U.S. Department of Education seeks to prevent colleges and banks from pushing accounts with high fees on students. The department said the regulations would give students greater choice in how they receive refunds from their student aid after college tuition and fees are paid. As it stands now, some colleges have entered into agreements with banks to outsource the distribution of those refunds through debit accounts or prepaid cards in exchange for financial considerations. Students are often enticed to choose these accounts, which often have high overdraft fees because they may receive their refunds faster this way, according to the Department of Education. Under the proposed regulation, students would not be required to open a certain account in order to receive refunds. Banks assisting colleges with payments of refunds would be required to ensure students aren't charged overdraft fees. Institutions must provide a list of account options to students. Colleges must ensure that payments made to students' pre-existing accounts must be made within the same time frame as those to bank accounts marketed by the college. Consumer Banker Association President and CEO Richard Hunt criticized the proposed regulations, saying it will ultimately cost students more money. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports bullying in U.S. schools fell to a record low in 2013, with 22% of students reporting being bullied, according to the U.S. Department of Education. The figure had hovered at 28% or higher in biennial student surveys since 2005, according to the department. The number is based on school crime data for students aged 12 to 18 compiled by the Justice Department. Education Secretary Arne Duncan and Health and Human Services Secretary Sylvia Burwell called the drop welcome news after campaigns in recent years to tackle the problem. Burwell said in a statement, "Parents, teachers, health providers, community members, and young people are clearly making a difference by taking action and sending the message that bullying is not acceptable." The drop in bullying was seen across various groups. In 2013, about 24% of female students reported being bullied at school, down from as high as 1 out of every 3. 19% of male students said they had been bullied, down from a high of 32% in 2006. Bullying is more common in lower grades, with 28% of 6th graders and 23% of 9th graders reporting being bullied. The figure drops to 14% for high school seniors. The figures are based on a poll of 4,942 students done for the school crime supplement to the Justice Department's National Crime Victimization Survey. The Education Department said there were three types of bullying: physical, social, and verbal. Students who are bullied are more likely to struggle in school and skip class. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to a new report, the vast majority of Americans simply want to be safe, happy, rich, comfortable, entertained, thin, and romantically fulfilled. The Onion spoke to a few of the survey's respondents who also claimed that